Hello, welcome to a p5.js video tutorial about how to use CodePen with p5.js. Now, CodePen is a web browser-based code editor. It allows you to type some HTML stuff in this box here. It allows you to type some CSS stuff in this box over there. And then in that box on the end that I can't reach because my arms will get cut off, you can type some JavaScript stuff. So there's a lot to CodePen. I'm sure there's a lot of features. You might be watching this as an archive video, but I'm actually doing this as a live stream. And I'm using something called CodePen Professor Mode. And there are 27 people watching me live code this right now at this very moment. But what I want to do is just make a quick p5.js sketch and see how it works with CodePen and some of the features of CodePen that I might discover along the way. Because I actually haven't really used CodePen before. I'm discovering this as I make this tutorial. Okay, so first thing we want to do is, let's look under settings here, and I want to go under JavaScript. So one thing that I want to do is I want to make available the p5.js JavaScript libraries. Now, I could add references to those in the HTML file, but since CodePen has this feature, I can actually just add a URL to my JavaScript library right here. And now, how do I find the p5.js JavaScript library? It just so happens that if I Google CDN, by the way, stands for Content Delivery Network, because it's going to deliver. It's a network that will deliver our content, the content in this case being the p5.js library. And I'm going to do this, CDN p5.js. And we're going to come to this URL, which is cdnjs.com/library/p5.js. And now I'm going to see a whole bunch of URLs. Now, one that I want right here for the main p5.js library is this one. So I'm going to grab that. I'm going to copy it, and I'm going to go back to CodePen, and I'm going to place it in here. And then I'm going to add another. While I'm here, I might as well add, let's add the DOM library as well. So I'm going to get the DOM library, and I'm going to put that in here. And then hopefully I'm going to save and close. And now if I go back to settings, we should see that these files are referenced. And incidentally, popular JavaScript libraries that you might use are available directly right here. So if I wanted to use jQuery for whatever reason, I could just kind of go into this menu here. Okay, yay. Oh, ow, I have a giant pimple on my nose, and I just whacked it. It hurts. I don't know, if you zoom into the pixels, this is going to be permanently in this video forever now. But you can zoom in and try to find it. It's very, it's quite noticeable. Okay, save and close. Maybe I'll edit that out. I won't edit that out. It's just there. Okay, so now let's just see. So one thing I'm going to do is, I don't really care about CSS or HTML right now. I mean, I care about them. CSS and HTML, I care about you. But right now, they're not the primary focus. I just want to see if things are working. I'm going to add function setup. I'm going to say create canvas, 200, 200. I'm going to say background, 0. And I'm going to hit save. And look at that. There, p5.js sketch running in CodePen. I don't know, what else should we do in this tutorial? I didn't come up with something to make. Let's just make sure things animate. I'm going to add function draw. And I'm going to say ellipse, mouse X, mouse Y, 16, 16. I'm going to hit save. I hit command S, by the way, to save. And you can see now there is my sketch running. I could also add something like create P, which is part of p5 DOM. And I could say, this is a sketch. This is a painting sketch. And I'm hit Command S again. And you can see now there I have a paragraph element there. We could add something like, let's see, a print line test. Actually, let's add the mouse pressed function. Somebody in the chat is mentioning that create P sounds like something else. I guess that's true. Print line mouse X. So I want to look at the console. There's a console here, and I can click. And every time I click, you'll see this is very hard for you to see. So let's zoom in on this. You can see that I also have access to a console right here in CodePen. This is lovely to use. CodePen, I'm enjoying it quite well. Look, there's a chat here. Look, people are talking in the chat because they're watching this live. And I am also going to say change view. And I can now look at this. So you can see one of the nice things is there are different views here. So if I want to go to presentation or full page, I could click on that, or I could also just go up to the URL and type full here. And now you can see there's my sketch. So this is actually how you make a P5 sketch in CodePen. It was really quite easy. And I wish I had prepared to do some other stuff in this video. I'm going to just pause, and maybe this video will continue in a second where I do some more stuff. I'm back, and I've decided that it's okay to have a very short, just like 5-minute video that showed you very quickly how to use p5.js in a CodePen. So if I'm going to do this in future videos. If you have questions about it or features you want me to explore, please let me know in the comments or at the Rainbow Topics GitHub repository that is also linked to in the description of this video. Thanks for watching.